Hello everyone. In this video, we will learn about analog to digital converter. In the first part of this video, I will discuss about some basics of analog to digital converter. And in the last part of this video, I will perform the experiment in our laboratory. This is our objective. Our objective is to study the procedure of analog to digital conversion by counter method. There are many methods by which we can make a counter by which we can convert analog signal into digital signal, but here we are using counter method because this method is very easy and very cost effective. By using components like comparator, AND gate, pulse generator, binary counter, LEDs, 7 segment display and digital to analog converter, we can make a device. With the help of that, we can convert our analog signals into digital signals. This is our circuit diagram for analog to digital converter, and this is the main component of this device, which is known as comparator or operational amplifier. This is AND gate, this is binary counter, and this is DAC, that is digital to analog converter. This is the digital output. We know that an operational amplifier amplifies the signal, that is the difference between its inputs. That is, an operational amplifier can only amplify those signals, that is the difference between its non-inverting and inverting terminal. That is, if both has same signal, that is if I apply a voltage 3 here and 3 here, then this operational amplifier will produce 0 here. But if there is any difference between these two signals, that is, let's here I am applying 2, then this operation amplifier will amplify this difference signal here. So for conversion of analog to digital, first we have to reset the counter so that it can erase any residue in the counter. Then we have to give an analog signal, and by giving some pulse short here, we can convert a 4-bit analog signal into digital signal. Let's first, I am giving a 3 volt here, and since we reset the counter, here we can get 0. So there is difference between these two inputs, so we get 1 in the output of this operational amplifier. And I am giving a pulse here, so this 1 produce 1 to the output of the AND gate, and this signal activate this counter, and this counter will start counting from 1. That is, first it will give 1 to the DAC and check this difference, then it will give 2 the DAC and it will check this difference, and again and again. Since I am giving here 3, so first it will give 1 to the DAC, then DAC will convert this digital 1 into analog digital and an analog signal, that is 1. So in first we get 1 here, and since there is difference between 3 and 1, we again get 1 here, and again we get 1 here, and this again set the counter to count. So this counter now send 2 to the DAC, and this DAC will convert this 2 digital 2 into analog 2 and send 2 here. again there is a difference between these two inputs. So again this amplifier will send a signal to the AND gate, and again this AND gate send a signal to the counter, and again this counter send third digit to the DAC, that is 3. So at third time we will get 3 here. Now 3 is equal to 3, so we will get 0 in the output of this operational amplifier. And now there is difference between the input of the AND gate, that is 0 and 1. So this AND gate will produce 0 here. So now there is no signal, further signal to the counter. Now this counter will display the digit that is stored inside it, that is equal to 3 in this case. So corresponding to analog voltage 3, we can get its digital equivalent, that is 3, by using this analog to digital converter. Since it's a 4 bit converter, so we can produce only up to 4 digits here. So in this way we can convert analog signals into digital signals. These are the advantages of counter based analog to digital converter. That is, a counter based analog to digital converter is very simple to construct. It is less expensive. Its speed can be adjusted by adjusting the clock frequency. It is faster than dual slope type analog to digital converter. Now I am going to perform this experiment in our laboratory. This is our setup for analog to digital converter. By using this setup, we can convert an analog signal into a digital signal, and we can see various parts of this setup, that is comparator, AND gate, 4 bit counter. And by using these start and pulse buttons, we can start the process of conversion of analog to digital signal. First we have to connect this voltmeter in the circuit, and now I am turning it on. First I am giving a voltage 1. Now I am starting it, and by giving a pulse we can see I am applying an analog voltage of 1 volt and we are getting 1. And when I am giving a 2 volt, that is we are getting a glowing LED that placed at B, which is equivalent to 2 of digital. So in this way, by applying a analog signal, we can convert this analog signal into digital signal. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Thank you.